My name is Nick Mastascusa. I am the chief nuclear pharmacist here at the University of Iowa Hospitals and Clinics. I'm a professor in the University of Iowa College of Pharmacy, as well as the Department of Radiology at the University of Iowa Hospitals and Clinics. My job as a radiopharmacist is to prepare radiopharmaceuticals for use of diagnostic imaging and radiopharmaceutical therapy. We use instruments that are a little bit different than in other areas of pharmacy. We have a dose calibrator, which is an instrument that will tell us how much radioactivity is in the dose that we're about to inject into the patient. And the dose is as simple as a dose in a syringe that looks just like saline. So the day-to-day job of a nuclear pharmacist is preparing these radiopharmaceuticals, preparing radiopharmaceutical therapies. We do a lot of calculations on decay and dosing. We have some interaction with patients when it comes to questions about the radiopharmaceuticals, what's going to happen to them during the study, what it's doing in their body, things of that nature. One of the most rewarding things about this field is it's a bench chemistry field. We work in a radiopharmaceutical lab, which is set up a lot like a chemistry lab. We have a lot of instrumentation. We do a lot of drawing of doses using syringes, calculations, and modifications of those doses based on the activity and the half-life of the isotope that we're using. We use several different isotopes. But it's a real application of chemistry, physics, and physiology that you learn throughout your college career. It is different from other areas of pharmacy in that we don't have a whole lot of patient interaction as opposed to retail pharmacy or ambulatory pharmacy, but we do have a lot of interaction with physicians. We do communicate with physicians, referring physicians, and our radiology physicians about what is going on and any questions they may have about the radiopharmaceutical that the patient is going to receive. The tips for nuclear pharmacy does not have a residency. The training for nuclear pharmacy is completed after graduation from pharmacy school with a PharmD. There are some pharmacy schools that have training programs as part of their curriculum, but most schools, students will go to one of these other training programs to complete their authorized nuclear pharmacist training. After that, as long as you like bench chemistry, you like the mathematical calculations, and doing something that is different than most other pharmacists are going to do with learning how to handle radioactive materials and being able to confidently make those doses and dispense those doses. One of the drawbacks about nuclear pharmacy is our hours are usually pretty early in the morning, depending if it's a commercial radiopharmacy or an academic radiopharmacy like we're in here. You can be to work as soon as 1 or 2 in the morning, and which it has its good and bad parts of that, but you practice independently. There's not a whole lot of over-the-shoulder supervision when you're doing your job in the clean room. You're in there doing your job, and that's that. But it is a fantastic field. It is a rapidly growing field. Within the last decade, there have been numerous radiopharmaceuticals that have come onto the market for therapy. And there are several more in the pipeline that will be coming down. And this is going to have a significant effect on how these diseases are imaged and treated. And it's going to change a lot. It already has changed how some cancers are treated. So it is a very interesting field. It's a little rare. There's not too many of us. But we're always looking for good, motivated pharmacists who want to do something that's a little bit off the beaten path and have a fantastic career that they can enjoy.